unit I'm using right now just happens to be a CF-31, but the steps are the same regardless if you're on a CF-19, CF-30, 31. Really doesn't matter which machine it is. It's just the steps are the same. In device manager, if you look in device manager and you see the missing driver for the device, Qualcomm Gobi 2000, you know your software is not installed yet. To get the software, you just open up any web browser. It doesn't matter which one. And you go to Panasonic's website. I always just go through Google and type in Panasonic drivers. And the first link here says drivers, downloads, computers, and tablets support Panasonic. That'll take you to the page where you can get any drivers you need for your Panasonic Toughbook. The Gobi card drivers and all the other mobile broadband card drivers shows up under other downloads here. You click on the other downloads and then you go to the wireless carrier. And then if your card is a AT&T card, you would go here. If it's Sprint, you would go here, Verizon here. If it's a multi-carrier card, such as the Gobi 1000, 2000, 3000, and 5000, you would go to the multi-carrier tab. For the Gobi 2000 in specific, you click this link here that says register and download the CSA install pack for Gobi and Gobi 2000. It'll open up another page where you can choose to download. You have to fill out your email address. And your name. And then from there, you should be able to download it. It's just not letting me re-download it because I just did this a few minutes ago to make sure the link would work with the same information. But what it just registers you so that if there's it'll inform you if there's an updated version of the software before it'll let you download it, and then afterwards it'll start downloading. I have already downloaded the software and had it on my flash drive. I'm just copying it to the desktop now. Once you download the software, you just go ahead and you run the software. It'll ask you for permission to allow it to run. Go ahead and give it permission. You click next. There's a normal licensing agreement. Now at this step here, you can leave it to the default location, but unlike with most driver installation, I do not advise you do that for this because the computer restarts several times during the process and you always have to go back to the install location. So I always recommend that you install it directly on your desktop, on a folder on your desktop, just to make it easier for you to find the files once your computer restarts. It'll take a moment to extract all the files it needs. this software works for the Gobi 1000 and the Gobi 2000. The Gobi 3000 and the Gobi 5000 each have their own separate software that you use for those cards. Okay, so once it's done running, it'll pop the folder up showing all the extracted files that it just extracted. From there, you go ahead and you go to the appropriate folder. If you're installing the Gobi Gobi 1000, you go to the Gobi package. If you're installing the Gobi 2000, you go to the Gobi 2K package. From here, you run the setup application file, which is halfway down the bottom. It's going to ask you for permission for it to run. Go ahead and give it permission. Click Next. Install. And while it's installing, I like to have the device manager open. You don't have to, but I just like to have the device manager open so I can see and make sure that the drivers are going in all of the appropriate places. Now you can have it continue to search Windows Update for it. Eventually it'll install it based off the drivers it's installing. I always tell it to skip obtaining drivers from Windows Update for this specifically, because it's just going to keep searching and eventually have to use the drivers anyways. From here, it goes quicker if you just tell it to skip and to use the drivers that you're installing. Okay, as you can see, once it's done, it's going to ask you to restart. Go ahead and let it restart. Okay, so once your computer restarts, I would advise opening up the device manager just to check and make sure that everything installed correctly for the drivers. It'll show up under ports, under network adapter, under modem, and it will show up under USB as well. As you can see here, it shows up under modem, network adapter, ports, and under the USB as well. Okay, so you have the drivers installed. Now comes the part of actually installing the software. For this step, you can either, one, if you're unsure of your software or if you're setting it up for somebody else, install the CSA pack, which allows you, it's just a software that allows you to more easily set up your carrier software, rather it's Verizon, AT&T, or Sprint. Or you can go directly to the WAN folder and install specifically for AT&T, Sprint, or Verizon. For this example, I'm just going to go ahead and install the carrier selection application. It just takes a few moments to install. It's going to need to restart after it's done installing that. Go ahead. The speed of the separate installs has to deal with the processor in your computer, the amount of RAM you have, the operating system you're running, if you have a solid state drive or not. For example, if I had a solid state drive in here and I had 16, it had 8 or 16 gigs of RAM, it would move a lot faster. As is, I only have 2 or 4 gigs of RAM in here, and it's a standard hard drive. Okay, so once the carrier selection application is installed, from there you'll just open the carrier selection application. It's going to ask you if it's okay for the program to run. Go ahead. Click next. Choose your carrier, whether it's Verizon, Sprint, or AT&T. For this example, I'm just going to choose Verizon. You click next, start, and it'll install the software for you with all the settings in the various carrier softwares that you need. After that's done, all you have to do is activate the card on your network. And depending on which network you're using, which carrier you're using, you may need a SIM card. The Gobi 1000 and 2000s on Verizon, for example, do not require SIM cards because they're only 3G cards. If it's just a 3G card, you don't need a SIM card. With the 4G cards, you do require a SIM card, regardless of which carrier you're using. So that's it for today's video. I've showed you how to install, where to go to get the drivers and software for the Gobi 2000 and how to install it. If you have any questions, any comments, or any suggestions, just let us know. You can contact us at our tech support email of tech_support@bobjohnson.com, or you can give us a call at our toll-free number of 877-202-7788. That's it for today. If you have any questions, just let us know. Thank you. Have a good day.